हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज बिनी तुम्बी मुतुम एंड यू आर वाचिंग इमोनू लाइव टॉप 20 न्यूज। द इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया इशूड अ वार्निंग टू आसाम चीफ मिनिस्टर हिमंत बिस्व शर्मा एंड कॉशन्ड हिम टू स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलो द प्रोविजंस ऑफ मॉरल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट व्हाइल मेकिंग पब्लिक अटरेंस। A notification has been released by the Assam Public Works Road Department (PWRD) regarding maximum speed limit set for vehicles of all classes on PWD roads apart from national highways. A human chain program has been called by the Citizens Coordination Committee on 27th of October in Guwahati to oppose the construction of a footbridge over the bank of Brahmaputra from Sankardev Udyan, Bharulmukh. The current Mizoram Chief Secretary L. Chuango appointed as the new Chief Information Commissioner CIC of the state. He will retire voluntarily as the Mizoram Chief Secretary in the end of October. A multi-sport arena developed in an area of more than 30,000 feet with futsal court measuring 8,250 square feet has been inaugurated by the Sikkim Chief Minister Prem Singh Tamang. Sikkim Chief Minister Prem Singh Tamang and Governor Ganga Prasad greeted people on the occasion of Labab Dwachen, celebrated by the Buddhists as the reincarnation of Gautam Buddha on earth. A special court convicted 9 of the 10 accused in the 2013 Patna serial blast case during the hookah rally of then Prime Ministerial candidate Narendra Modi. 6 people were killed and 19 injured in the blast. A Guwahati-based nutritionist Dr. Basanti Barua was named Food Hero of India by Center for Quality and Food Safety Delhi for her contributions towards the eradication of child malnutrition, traditional food knowledge and nutrition education in India. Petrol and diesel prices hiked after a 2-day pause. The prices increased between 35 to 40 paise per litre across the country. More than Rs. 2.5 crore has been looted in the name of PM Kisan Samman scheme. Huge amount of money has been released in the name of 39 lakh fake farmers in the scam. A meeting regarding vaccination drive, pandemic emergency package and the Ayushman Bharat health infrastructure was conducted with Union Health Minister Mansukh Mandavya and State Health Ministers in Vigyan Bhavan, New Delhi. Supreme Court ordered to set up an expert committee for examining the use of Pegasus spyware against Indian citizens and whether their right to privacy has been violated. 13 airports to be bid on public-private partnership. The process to be completed by March as planned by the central government. India is fully determined to protect its maritime interest while it supports the maintenance of rule-based maritime systems as mandated under UN Convention of the Law of Seas 1982, as stated by Raksha Mantri Shri Rajnath Singh while delivering the keynote address at Indo-Pacific Regional Dialogue 2021. Union Minister of MME Shri Narayan Rane launched Sambhav, a national level awareness program 2021 to promote entrepreneurship for the economic development of the country. NMDC celebrates Self-Reliance with Integrity Vigilance Awareness Week 2021 by organizing various activities, competitions and sensitization programs on integrity commemorating India at 75. On the 75th Infantry Day, the Indian Air Force remembers role of vintage aircraft Parshuram in transporting troops of the 1st Sikh Regiment to Srinagar during the war with Pakistan in 1947. Sukmawati Sukarnoputri, the daughter of the first Indonesian president Sukarno, converted to Hinduism on her 70th birthday. Genesis Electrified G80 selected as an official VIP car for G20 Bali Summit 2022 as announced by the Indonesian government. Today's Assam COVID-19 update. Total positive cases 244. Recovery rate 98.39%. Death case 6. That's all for today. Thanks for watching Immuno Life.